Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Blockchain Central. In this video, we'll talk about private and public keys, see how they are used, and why they matter in the world of crypto. We will also look at encryptions, which is a big part of cryptocurrencies. Public and private keys are both needed for asymmetric encryption. To get started, it is helpful to first look at symmetric encryption, something that we are all familiar with. Before the dawn of the digital age, encryption relied on a secret key. The key served to both encrypt and decrypt secret messages. A good example was the Caesar cipher. In case you didn't know, Caesar encrypted all his letters. He replaced every letter with one placed three letters earlier in the alphabet. So hello becomes ebel. This technique not only required all his partners to have the same key, but also had two other downsides. Everyone on the network could read everything. An attacker could capture the key from just one member of the network, which would compromise the entire network. Asymmetric encryption, on the other hand, uses two different keys. The best visual example of this is your traditional mailbox. You can easily share your address with people. However, you won't share the physical key to the mailbox. So knowing your address allows me to send you a letter, but only you can read it. If you know my address, you can write back, but only I can read it. The trick is to have a private key. Here it is, the physical key to the mailbox. It allows reading while the public key only allows sending. That's the gist. But how do these digital keys work in practice? Why can't I recreate the private key after receiving the public one? Asymmetric encryption emerged after computers appeared. To create a digital key, complex algorithms are used to create long numbers. These numbers are connected in a specific way. As a result, the information about the public key is stored inside the private key, but not the other way around. Sadly, we still haven't found a perfect, bulletproof way of achieving this yet. Therefore, we have to rely on a more practical barrier: computing power. Asymmetric encryption relies on a complicated math problem. It is created to be so difficult that it takes a very long time to calculate. Even the best computers we have in the world will not be able to calculate it quickly. Importantly, the public key, once created, doesn't help in creating the private key. If you tried, it would take hundreds of years on the best computers in the world. That way, we can send information to someone that only they can read. Alternatively, you can use it to receive bitcoins, which only you can spend. It is, however, the case that algorithms for breaking such encryptions are getting better. Breaking means they use methods to guess the private key. The private key gives them access to the information it protects. This is called breaking the encryption. To stay safe, we have to use longer and longer keys. A 512-bit key was considered safe in 1995, but it is not advisable to use it in 2018, at least not for important things. The US government currently uses 2048-bit keys for low-level encryptions, and we truly don't know much about their high security options. So far, the length of a safe key is increased a bit every year, but there's a problem. It is feared that quantum computing will make most of today's encryptions obsolete. Quantum computers work differently, making them much faster than the current ones. Once they arrive, the massive increase in computing power will be able to break all today's keys, but researchers are already designing algorithms to keep us safe. So what does all of this have to do with blockchain? Well, whenever you use digital currency, you will be using some variety of private and public keys. Many exchanges will do that part for you. That way, you can go ahead and interact with blockchain via email and password. But behind the scenes, they use key pairs for you to interact with the blockchain. This is the reason it is better to keep your funds in an offline wallet, as it is safer to be in control of your private key. Anyone who knows your public address can send you coins, but only you, with the private key, can spend that money. Okay, so what have we learned today? In asymmetric encryption, a public and private key are used. To encrypt or send information, you need a public key. For decryption, retrieval of information, you use a private key. A multitude of different algorithms is used today. At the core, they all rely on a very difficult math problem. The method is safe because no one has enough computing power to break it. That is it for this episode of Blockchain Central. Before you go, please note that this video does neither represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Happy investing.